Okay, welcome to yet another Soccer Manager 2023 Bath United Romans video. Now, here is the next game versus Bromley. We're going to go to the league. You see where we are sitting at the moment. I believe we're in like 16th, we're in 18th. Even worse than I thought. Remember, we're aiming for 5th to 2nd this year. Okay. Well, hopefully things can get a bit of a better on our front foot from here on out, from this episode on. Doug Dowd is injured, which I did not know about going into this. Cam definitely can't go forward. Can Hagen go forward? Hagen can go forward. There we go, we'll do that.
We'll bring Matt in. Cool. Actually, Dolan here. Dolan can come in for... who that was, Eden. Is it the best we can do? Because I believe it is. Yes, there is Doyle, but he's injured. Does it, Eden, the best player there. Is Demi a first team player now? Was he always our first team player? I forget sometimes, I don't know why. Okay, let's go.
Actually, one thing I should check before we get going is... tactics. Play the channels. Okay, first game of the episode at Hayes Lane versus Bromley. Hopefully it can end in a win. Let's find out. Oh, I should be turning on Do Not Disturb before we get a highlight ruined again like 3 episodes ago. Okay, on the ball here is Hagen pushing forward on that left side. Goes around 2 players, does lose to the second. So this would be who? Jepson on the ball. Yes, it is. Jepson puts the ball in. Into the head of Sam Gowan, who puts us in the lead 15 minutes in. That's the style we wanted. No, I can't shout because it is late at night. As I always record these videos, it's going to be half time here, 1-0 up to us. Hagen, despite really creating that goal with a run down the left side, I know he didn't assist it or anything, but he really did create it. Still on a 5.3 rating though. We're going to leave it at that for now. Let's go. Okay, going forward on the ball here is, I didn't even see the name. Their keeper picks it up, puts it long into the path of Foster. Headed down over the top, and that is a goal for Lewis Dennis. Equaling it up. It was actually our keeper, I didn't realise. I thought we got the way around. Okay, corner here, 93rd minute. Ball in there from Hal Hepburn, I think it was. Actually, it would have been Kantorowski. Pem on the edge of the box, fakes out his opponent, passes it here to, who's that? Bate. Adam Bate, the centre back. Taps the ball round the player and then just fires at home in the left hand side. We are 2-1 up, 93rd minute. First win of the episode. Let's make it a few more than just one. I might turn this down a little bit so you can hear me a bit better. Okay, man of the match was the man of the match, really, the man of the day, Adam Bate with the winning goal. Adam Bate with a goal, Gowan with a goal, and Jepson with an assist in that game. Should have also been Pim with an assist because he passed the ball to Bate, but we actually had 10s there. Is this result the start of our charge? Mather wants more game time. Well, unfortunately, I cannot guarantee you any more than you've been getting. Board Reaction is very pleased with the win against Bromley today. Well, Bromley high on the table. Let's see. Normally that's when someone's massively above you on the table. I don't know, they're not that much higher than us. Okay, bid received for Bait. I'm not going to accept it, but I just want to see how much they offer. 60k, decent bid, not good enough though. I want to see at least 100 for them. Even then I wouldn't let them go. Okay, match review here. Aldershot versus us, obviously, Bath United. We will be, I think we were at home. I get the team done, I'll be back with you. Okay, we're going to go with that for now. We're going to leave Bate on despite being a little bit tired. We're pulling Egan for whoever went off. Who went off? Demi. And as you can see, Barker is on for, who was it? Mulcahy with a switch for Hagen back in all positions. So we'll switch these guys back over. I didn't actually check if we were on Play the Channels. Hopefully we are. Okay, highlights straight off the back here. Minute 44. Knight pushing forward. Pem trying to chase. Entering their third. Long ball up. Chested down here by Baxter. And Baxter puts it away on the left-hand side of the goal. We're 1-0 down very early in the game. Okay, another chance here for them. Baxter on the ball. Heading it down. Into the path of Egan, who launches it out. Brought down here by Barker, who loses it. Another ball straight back in. Headed here, and it is... F-Wong, I don't know how to say that name, but he scored the goal. 2-0 down before half-time, Hagen on the ball here. Passes it further back to Egan, it was a long ball up. This is going to be brought down by their team, actually. Jordan launches it forward straight into the path of... I didn't see who that was. I'm assuming it was Matha. Connor collecting the rebound and putting it away. 2-1, we pull one back just before half-time. Gowing with a very poor performance at the moment. Let's see instructions first. We are on what we want to be. What's it called on fucking thingamajiggy? I can't think of the name. You know what I mean. Play the channels, that one. Okay, that's what we're going to do for now for our changes. Kantorovsky coming off for Jepsen. Dolan staying on despite being tired. We'll make no changes in the middle, but across the attacking midfield, everyone switching out. Even Kirby. Okay, and the ball here, Pem, makes a tackle, but Klaas just goes around him. Puts the ball across here. I think that was Effiong. Heads out wide here, across, but come back in. Straight back to the same guy. It was Effiong, and it is 3-1-2. Aldershot. Can we pull back a point here? Considering where this highlight is, I highly doubt it. It is a free kick right on the edge of the box. From the free kick, Gary Knight steps up and puts it straight in the top right-hand corner. Keeper had no chance. The game is well and truly out of our reach. Okay, Joe Partington with the man of the match there. With a 10, actually. Good on him. Our best players being three guys across the back line, Dolan, Bates and Egan. The goal from Evans, assist from Barker. Okay, a new team here, because we are... Oh, it's a FA Cup tie versus Cherry Wood Road, sorry. They are at home. We are away. We're just going to go with whatever team's on the field. Actually, I'm going to change up a little bit. I don't really care about the FA Cup. I'm not going to get anywhere anyway. So we'll give players who don't normally get a chance. Okay, there we go. We're going to start with that team. I'll go through it in a second when we get to the next ring. So, in the away game at Cherrywood Road against Cherrywood FC, that's the stadium. We're against Farnborough FC. So our squad is Tormey in goal with Dolan, Doyle, Egan and Kantorovsky across the back, Pem and El Hepburn in the middle. Our attacking midfielders are Ratcliffe, Broadbent, Matha with French up front. Now if we lose this game, I don't really care. Because we can have fitter players throughout the season later on if we do lose it. Midway through the game, there is no changes to any of the scoreline, so we're going to make changes to the team. Bring on some players who deserve to be in the squad, aren't just here because we're playing a bunch of shitters from a lower division. Dolan can stay on again. Okay, on the ball here is Kirby, who gets ball taken straight off him by Saunders. Put in the middle though, as if he was passing it to Pem, passes it back to Nye Kirby. Save made, but Nye Kirby gets the rebound. I can just tap it in. 61 minutes, we're 1-0 up. I was hoping for a more confident win, but 1-0, I'll take it, it's a win. Man of the match being the one and only Nye Kirby, with the goal, obviously, and a 10 rating. Tormey in goal, getting a 9, as well as Kantorovsky and Dolan. So next time we're versing Alshancham in the FA Cup. Could have been anyone, had to be them though. Couldn't be a name I can actually pronounce. Look at the size of that draw, bloody hell. Okay, next match is like a day or so since the last one. 2 days against Burrow. Thank God I did do what I did there, otherwise we've had a completely spent team. Okay, there we go, that's the team we're going to go with. So it is Kantorovsky and Dolan on the outsides. Bring basically the full defence back, Lawson, Demi, Bate. Pem is going to be on the bench. In fact, I'll probably just pull Pem out completely, but there's no one that can come in, so he may as well stay there, actually. and probably shouldn't start with Ratcliffe because I want him to be able to replace Evans if Evans isn't playing very well. The Mather's on the wrong side now, so I'll bring Malkinski in. Forward line is pretty similar to normal, not much changes, you can see them yourself. Okay, we have to try and strike early here, which we've done stats wise but not on the score sheet yet, because we are probably going to peter out later in the game and start conceding, if not at least losing control of the game. We've not managed to penalise them from early control. I don't know who I'm going to put in for Dolan. Have to put somebody. Might have to be Pem, even though he's pretty tired himself. Benares can come into the midfield. Ratcliffe can come out here. And I believe that's all the subs that we can make. So we'll have to leave Barker on. Deep in this match, is still goals, but there's going to be a chance here. On the ball is Naya Kirby. Taps the passes man to Ratcliffe, who pushes forward, gets the ball back here to Kirby, who loses it for a second, gets it back, takes a shot, and what a goal. Naya Kirby from a long shot just outside the box. After losing possession, rifles it to the top left. Keeper had no chance. Okay, Naya Kirby pushing forward again. Getting close to entering our forward third. What's he going to do? He's putting himself in a bit of a corner here. Puts a long ball in. Perfectly to the feet of Evans. Who can just clinically finish at home. Keeping his calm. Doing his job. 90 minutes and it's 2-0 up for us. It's going to be a good win because we were a very depleted squad going into this game. There it is. 2-0 win. Let's go. Okay, Naya Kirby made the man of the match as he deserves. As I said, late last season, he's been our best player since he has joined. Another 10 there for Lawson and a 9 for Evans. Obviously, Kirby getting an assist and a goal. Evans getting a goal. And I believe there was no other assist, was there? No. Finally starting to string a few results together, even if one of them was the FA Cup. Do we still sit? We've actually gone down, I think, weren't we, in 15th? Actually, no, we were 18th. 15th was one of our editors today. So 16th position, we have now gone up 2 positions since the start of the episode. Let's make it a few more. Board are very pleased with our result against Barrow, as I would be considering the position we were in going into it. Obviously another injury, because we love injuries to this team. And I'm just going to straight up reject this without even checking the prices they gave us. Because bait is going nowhere. Okay, before we do the last game of the episode, we have a few things here to check, like the loan report for Fitzy. He's now a 50 overall player. Club player of the month, let's see who it is. I would give it to Naya Kirby, but I would say considering these guys are here and positions they're playing in, I'd probably give it to Dolan. He even gets it. Okay, God knows how that happens, but are we going to be one start? No, no stars. Team of the week, we have 3 players. We have Lawson, Demi and Bate across that back line. I hate when players say that they must be in the team. You must do what I tell you to. You are my player. You do not demand things. You ask things. So you will not be starting. In fact, you will be on the bench. Not even on the bench. You'll be in the reserves. I don't care if you're one of the best players in the team. If you want to demand things, you can sit out. Okay, so we're going to go with that team. We're going to go with Broadbent covering for Hagen's stupidity, because Pem is not fit enough still currently to take that position. And I want to give Broadbent the opportunity? We'll leave it with Broadbent at the moment because he's the more experienced player in the squad. Malkinski actually shouldn't be there anymore. Gowan should be in that position. Well, actually, let's go. I think Ratcliffe's the more suited to being in that role. He's been doing more than Gowan in recent times. So yeah, that's the 2 changes really, and I guess Mulcahy's in because he was at the last game. They're the only changes from the squad last time. Let's go. Last game of the episode, let's make another win. We are versing Yeovil Town at the Royal Victoria Stadium. I forgot to check the if we're doing the play through the channels thing, but first highlights here. Ball is with Mulcahy, who turns his man, loses it for a second, gets the long ball up, headed here from Evans, and Connor Evans opening the score sheet for the day, 10 minutes in, 1-0 to us. Let's go. Okay, I'm not going to try with that name, Koya or something. Loses the ball there, but it goes straight back into the path of Richard Evanson. Long ball in. Beautiful header from Alex Fisher, and it's 1-1. Just before half time, which is a bit annoying. Another chance here. Nye Kirby, defensive header there, goes straight to Owls. Richardson, Everton. Long ball up here, didn't see where that was in the end. Fisher with another shot. And in 2 minutes, they've gone from 1-0 down to 2-1 up going into the break. I'm going to be a bit risky here and go with the all-out attack. Make some changes to this squad. Okay, we're going to do that for now. As you know, I've put on all-out attack. We've made a few changes which you would have seen. I actually forgot what they were now, but you would have seen them in the fast-forward. Let's go. This could very much backfire, but I like being aggressive in my style of play. Going for the win. Pem on the ball here. Passes to Jepson. It goes all the way back to Demi. Long ball up. Nye Kirby headers it down into the path of Evans. Connor Evans takes his shot off the inside of the post, and it's 2-2. 66 minutes. Can we not concede this second half? Maybe not. Definitely not. Ball here with the guy, I can't really pronounce him the name of. 82nd minute. Takes the shot, save, straight into the path of Pierre. And Kyrie Pierre puts them in front again. 3-2 the oval. 82 minutes. We have 7 minutes to reply. Can we do it? No, we cannot. We lose another game. It's been a better episode, but we still need to get better than this if we want to do anything this season. And I don't really fancy a third season in the National League, I'm not going to lie. I mean, we had good ratings. We had 10s from Mulcahy with an assist, Kirby with an assist as well. Plenty of 9s, basically the whole defence, and Evans on 9s. Obviously the goals both coming from Evans. Okay, next episode is going to start with a game against Dorking Wanderers. We're going to check the table for the end of the episode. Let's see where we're sitting. I'm going to say probably back in 15th now. We've dropped back down to 16th, so we're 2 up of where we started. We are, what? How many points off where we're trying to get? We're 13 points off where we're trying to get to this season. And we are like 5 points off 10th-ish. Not quite. 6 points off 10th. I mean, we've lost to all the teams. Look at Maidenshead. After the last season when they were down here, they had like one win, like 20 games at one stage. They're a big improvement for them. I wish we could have done the same, but not to be. Hopefully it continues to improve next episode and we can start working our way up into more of these sorts of positions with the Dagenham and Maidenshead and Aldershot areas. Anyway, thanks, bye. See you next time. See ya. But it's never too late to start a new beginning. That goes for you too. So what the fuck you gonna do? Use the tools you're given, or you gonna use the card you dealt as an excuse for you to not do shit with them. I used to play the loser victim till I saw the way proof was driven. I found my vehicle and I haven't ran out of gas yet. And when they stack decks, turn handicaps into assets, fanny packs, hourglasses. If time was on my side, I'd still have none to waste. Man, am I young?